Yeah, we can hear you.
Yes.
That's awesome. Brad?
How are you, Brad?
I'm great. Brett Goldstein, Phil Dunster joining us here in Detroit. Guys, thank you so much for being a part of this. Ted Lasso has been such a hit. I know the question I'm sure you get asked most is, what is it like to be on such a positive, feel-good show? But I'll take it a step further. You blend comedy, you blend real drama, and you do it all in a sports show. It's easier said than done. How do you think you guys pulled it off?
Good question. Oh, man, good vibes.
Good. You're coming hard. You're coming hard up top.
Well, I mean, Brett, this is Brett, or I don't know where he is on your screen, but this is Brett, he's a writer. I think from my perspective, from an actor's perspective, I think that the way that they managed to blend the two is that, you know, there's time spent with each of the actors and really so that they understand, you know, what the depths of the character actually is, what they're going through. And then they get that bedrock and then, you know, there's just so many funny people on set. Brett, namely, you've got Brendan Hunt, you've got Joe Kelly, and you've got Jason Sudeikis, and we had Bill Lawrence there as well. And these are all creators of the show and execs on the show. And they're like, I'm like, okay, how do I, what's the joke? How do I make it funny? And they're like, you do it like this. And then I just copy what they do. It's so much easier when I do that.
He's being very self-deprecating. He's a funny boy. He's fun.
I read in multiple interviews, Brett, that Roy Kent, your character, I love the character development throughout the show. But I read that you said Roy Kent is a lot of you. So does that mean you just walk around the set grunting and cursing at everybody all day, every day?
Yeah. You've seen the backstage footage, yeah. I'm horrendous on set. I'm a notoriously frightening presence. But I get the job done.
Jason Sudeikis at the helm of this, leading the way for season one, obviously coming up with the character for the sketches that came up before all of this. What has it been like with him at the helm, leading the way through season one now and the planning of season two?
Jason is amazing. Like, you know, you've seen the show. He's an amazing actor and an amazing comedian. But in terms of the writing and show running, like, he is the, you know, there's all these voices and stories and ideas and actors and everyone that all go through this conduit, the final conduit, which is Jason. And he knows the show and everything so instinctively and so in such detail. Anyone can ask him anything, like, why this, what's this? And he knows, like, a kind of, I don't want to say this, but it's true, sort of like a god, like, oversees this entire world. He knows exactly, in really minute detail, every single moment of the show. So you're never lost. If there's anyone that has any question at any point, it's like, this is this, this is that. And that's taking in everything that everyone brings and then putting it through this finer point. Does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely. Phil, for you, you guys released this show during a pandemic. Was there concern at all from you and the crew that, man, maybe we shouldn't do this right now? Like, morale around the world is so low. Or were you really confident when you were putting this thing together, it didn't matter when you released it, that the results and the appreciation would happen and unfold like it did?
Well, Brad, first of all, I want to say thank you for thinking that I had any say in when the show came out at all. I know what you're saying. I think that, you know, there were shows that came out in over here. There was a show called Normal People, which I don't know if you guys had over there. I think it's a Hulu show. But anyway, there were shows that came out over the pandemic before this show came out. And I think that I was like, no, I think that the running theme in what we need right now is hope and togetherness and, like, reminder that the world is, that people are good. And I believe that people want to be, help other people be better. And I think that one of the cool things about this show and about Ted Lasso is that he, you know, I don't think that it's a spoiler to say that, you know, one of his sort of mantras is, I want to make these gentlemen the best human beings that they can be. And it's, you know, not necessarily based upon winning and losing. And I think that reassessing how it is that we define, you know, doing well and progressing, not in wins and losses, I think is it felt like a really important thing at the time when it came out. And I think that it, you know, that we always need that at any time, but it certainly didn't feel like when we make this and when that pandemic comes in 6 months that no one knows about, it's going to be, you know, it's going to sit really well. But no, it felt like it came out at a good time.
I want you guys both to answer this question. This show is a successful sports show. There have not been a lot throughout the course of TV history. As the buzz for this show continues to pick up and people discover it, is there something selfishly you'd love to see? Would you love to see a Roy Kent action figure or perhaps a trading card? I mean, how big would you love to see this, something to have maybe as a collectible now that you guys are soccer football stars basically around the world?
I think we'd all love an official FIFA team with our characters. Because we do play ourselves, but it would be great if it was like officially.
Yeah, we have a FIFA team, but if
FIFA did a FIFA team and sort of made us look a bit more like us, that would be huge.
Yeah,
I'll take an action figure if you're making one, sure.
I'm a sports reporter in Detroit, and I found this show. I have been flying the flag of it as loudly and proudly as possible. I love it. I thank you guys so much for the patience you had in dealing with us today, but thank you for making the show and for being so gracious with us here.
Thank you so much,
man. That's really kind of you.
Thank you.
Thanks, bro. Thank you.
Absolutely. Talk soon, guys. Good luck with the awards, too.
Thank you very much.